Now coming to bending stresses in beams, we have only one major formula. M by I is equal to sigma by y equal to E by R, and also a term which is known as section modulus, which is given by z equal to I by y. For rectangular section, the section modulus is given by z is equal to bh square by 6, and for circular section it is given by pi d cube by 32. Next topic is shear stresses in beams. In this also we have one major formula, which is tau equal to vq by ib, where q is equal to ay bar. Also remember one thing, for any section the shear stress varies parabolically. For rectangular section, the maximum shear stress occurs at center, which is equal to 3 by 2 of tau average. Similarly, for circular section, the maximum shear stress occurs at the center, which is equal to 4 by 3 of tau average. Now coming to thin cylinders and spheres, the formula for circumferential stress or hoop stress is given by sigma c equal to pd by 2t, and for longitudinal stress it is given by pd by 4t. Now using these two equations to find the strains, we get circumferential strain as pd by 2te multiplied by 1 minus mu by 2, and longitudinal strain is given by pd by 2te multiplied by half minus mu, and the volumetric strain is given by pd by 2te multiplied by 5 by 2 minus 2 mu. Coming to thin spheres, the formula for circumferential stress and longitudinal stress remains same. This is equal to pd by 4t, and both the strains are also equal, which are pd by 4te multiplied by 1 minus mu, and the volumetric strain is equal to 3pd by 4te multiplied by 1 minus mu. The next topic is torsion in shafts. This also has a major formula, which is T by J equal to tau by R equal to G theta by L. Now we have term known as torsional stiffness, and it is given by KT equal to T by theta equal to GJ by L.